Good morning, all of you. We now discuss Toni Morrison. American Ritigariana, Toni Morrison. And she was born in 1931 and she died in 2019, some 2 years before. And she died at the age of 88. And she was born in Ohio. She was a black lady. She became a popular novelist, essayist, editor and teacher. And she actually explored black American experience, particularly the black female experience. In her novels, we come to find Toni Morrison speaking about the black female experience. And most of her novels deal with the problems faced by the black American ladies. So it's a fact that there is color distinction and discrimination in the European countries, including America. So the black people are considered as second-rate people, and the white people with the bluest eyes are considered beautiful, able, the best in the society. And there is always the discrimination. Even after the Emancipation Proclamation, so the proclamation that makes the white and black equal, the discrimination still continues. And we come to find that there are many number of American Negro writers like Richard Wright, James Baldwin, and Ralph Waldo Ellison speaking against the discrimination. And Toni Morrison can be included in the group of the Negro writers. And she was born in Ohio, and her first play was Dreaming Emmett. It was her first play. And it tells the story of the murder of a black teenager. The question is, the murder of a black teenager named Emmett Till. And The Bluest Eye seems to be her first novel. And it was produced in 1970. And then she received a Pulitzer Prize for her novel, The Beloved. And she also won the American Booker Award also in 1988 for her novel, Beloved. And it is the most popular of her novels. The story of a black woman named Margaret Garner, found killing her 2-year-old daughter. And she never wanted her daughter to grow and to become a slave like her. Normally the black ladies will be made to become prostitutes, sexually molested by the whites. And she doesn't want her daughter to grow up and to face such a fate. In fact, she killed her daughter only when the child is 2 years of age. And she wanted to kill herself also, but she was prevented from doing it. And she was put in the jail. And her daughter returns to her as a ghost. And she is called Beloved. The child is also called Beloved. So the discrimination felt by the black Negro women seemed to be the major subject of Toni Morrison. And Toni Morrison received the Presidential Medal of Freedom from Barack Obama. And Toni became a Catholic, and she adopted Anthony as her baptismal name. Anthony, and the short form of it is Toni. So the nickname Toni came out of the baptismal name Anthony. And she also produced the biography of the great boxer Muhammad Ali, who was originally called Cassius Clay. And The Bluest Eye is her first novel. and it was produced in 1970. And the novel actually describes the sufferings of the Negro girls. And we come to find that there are a few girls in the novel suffering because of the discrimination. And the main character is Piccola Breedlove, and she is the protagonist of the novel. And she is the one who longs to have blue eyes. And she is always feeling very bad because of her bad color and the color of her eyes. And at school she was considered as an ugly girl. And therefore she always wanted to have blue eyes. But her friends Claudia and Freda, they never liked blue eyes. They never wanted to have blue eyes. But Piccola wishes to have blue eyes. And the title of the novel is The Bluest Eye. And very interestingly, the novel has a very special structure. The novel is split into an untitled prelude and four large units. The novel is divided into four larger units, and each named after a season. And the first part of the book is autumn. And the season actually begins with the autumn. And it is followed by winter, spring and summer. And the book is actually narrated by a young girl named Claudia McTeal. And Claudia McTeal is the first person narrator in the first section of each of the four units. In each of the four units, we come to find the opening of the units are done by a young girl named Claudia, and she is Claudia McTeal, and she is only 9 years old. And it is she who tells the story of Piccola Breedlove. And she is a friend of Piccola. When she is 9 years, Piccola is 12 years. And Claudia has got a sister also. And her sister is named Freda. And she is aged 10 years. And Piccola's mother is Pauline. And her brother is Sammy. And when we go into the story of Piccola Breedlove, born in a very poor family, and her mother is handicapped with a few tooth missing from her mouth, and she had been doing the work of a housemaid, working in the various houses of the English people. And her husband is a drunkard. And Pauline is found working under the English family, the white family, called the Fishes. And she has lame foot and missing tooth also. And after all, her husband is a drunkard. And even though he is the father of Piccola Breedlove, he sexually harasses Piccola, rapes her also. So in the novel, we come to find the father raping his daughter and making her pregnant. And after all, when we go into the story, we come to find that Piccola wishes to have blue eyes. And she is always ashamed because she is dirty because of her black color. But the friends named Claudia and Freda, they don't actually want to have blue eyes. And Claudia doesn't actually like to have a white color body also. And when she was given a doll to play, a white doll with the blue eyes, she broke the doll into pieces. And she doesn't actually like the white color or the blue eyes. But Piccola, on the other hand, always wishes to have blue eyes. So they get, so that she can have some importance in the society. And Piccola, I told you, becomes raped by her father, Choli. And Choli seemed to be a problem maker in the house. And he used to reach home fully drunk and quarreled with his wife. And even burned down the house also. And when he burned down the house, Piccola is forced to go and stay with the McTeer family. She comes to stay with the McTeer family for a few days. And it is during the time she menstruates for the first time. The experience of a girl. So menstruating for the first time while staying with the McTeers. And Piccola, after all, becoming pregnant by her father, suffers again a lot. Still, she wishes to have blue eyes. And she meets a man who claims to have some magical powers. And he is a fortune teller named Soaphead Church. Very interestingly, he is called Soaphead Church. And when Piccola wanted him to have blue eyes, he promised to provide her blue eyes. Under the condition that Piccola should kill a dog owned by his house owner named Bertha Rees. And so the man, the fortune teller, tells Piccola that if she will kill the dog, the suffering of the dog, and after all, when the dog will be dead, it will show some action of suffering, and the suffering will actually give her the blue eyes. And the fortune teller gives Piccola poisoned bread. In fact, it you give it to the dog. And Piccola gives it to the dog. And the dog eats and suffers the death sufferings. And after all, the dog is named Bob. And remember the name of the dog, B-O-B, Bob. And the dog dies. And after all, the owner of the dog comes and quarrels with Piccola. And Piccola actually becomes mad after the incident. And she spends her life as a mad woman after the incident of killing the dog. And in the novel, we come to find there are a few prostitutes also present, named China, Poland and Mary. And they are found quarreling all the time and abusing Piccola also. And very interestingly, the title of the novel are like Dick and John, and there are such type of titles being given to the chapters. And basically the novel divided into four parts as Autumn, Winter, Spring and Summer. And the novel actually tells the sufferings of a Negro girl named Piccola Breedlove. And she doesn't get support from her brother also, named Sammy. And Sammy actually assisted the mother in beating the father. And Piccola at the end becomes insane, still dreaming of the blue eyes. And these are the details we learn from Toni Morrison's novel, The Bluest Eye. Thank you.